Yeah, welcome to my talk about performance optimizations for Apache Camel. Before I start, I should mention I'm jet-lagged. So I'm based in Germany. It took me 17 hours to come to Portland, and so we have a time difference from 9 hours. I wake up 3 o'clock in the morning. If I make any mistakes, so please excuse. So after a brief introduction, I want to talk about performance optimizations for our common components and common enterprise integration patterns. And by doing this, I will also talk about a few core concepts, core interfaces, and core classes we have in Camel, and you will see during this demonstration. And at the end, we will have roughly 10 minutes for question and answers. If I'm running out of time, I'm here in this room for the rest of the day. Feel free to contact me and ask questions. Okay. So, my name is Christian Müller. I'm a senior software developer at Artus Worldline in Frankfurt, Germany. In this company, I'm technically responsible for our integration platform, which is based on ServiceMix and Apache Camel. Since almost 11 years, I architecture and develop enterprise integration solution based on Java for the enterprise, mostly banking, finance, and telco sector. I came into contact with Camel around about 4 years ago by working on a new project. I'm a regular committer since more than 2 years, and shortly after I was invited to join the Camel PMC. And since the end of 2011, I was elected to be the Camel PMC chair. Before I start my presentation, I would like to invite you to take part of our discussion about Camel 3.0. It's our next major release. And we started a few discussions a few weeks ago, and we would like to know what you dislike in Camel, who you are seeing improvements, and which feature you are missing, and so on. So please be involved on our mailing list or IRC. Tell us your ideas, your wishes, and yeah, be part of Camel 3.0. Okay, let's start. First, I want to show some performance optimizations for content-based routing, one of the most common enterprise integration patterns. And in this case, I use an XML message, which looks like this. So it's a SOAP message with many, 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 many orders. It's round about 10K in size. Okay, I started with a base route test so that I don't have to repeat all the setup for each different test I have. This class extends Camel test support. This is one class from our test kit which should be used if you test your Camel route, and if you do not use Spring or Blueprint or some other things. Okay. The test itself is simple. I have a template. This template is an instance variable which comes from the camel test support. It's a producer template. And on this producer template, I set the default endpoint URI so that I don't have to repeat this for each test execution. Then I use simply IO utils from commons IO to read my test file into memory. Then I warm up my system a little bit. That's done here. I use the mock component, set my expectations, so I expect 10,000 messages in this component, and I also tell the mock component the component should not store all the messages because if you do some large or the big test, then it's possible to run out of memory or have some performance impacts. Then I send 10,000 messages with this payload to this direct start endpoint. Then I wait until all the messages arrived at this endpoint, and then I reset my mock endpoint. I do this only to warm up my system, and afterwards I do my real test, which is really similar, and I use the stopwatch to measure the time I need for this execution. Okay, let's start with a XSparse route test. As Kai in the previous talk said, normally you would, in this place, you would instantiate your route builder and use this route builder, but for convenience, do not switch to many sites. I use an anonymous inner route builder class and describe my route. And this routes listened on an direct start endpoint. It used Joyce, this camel way to implement a content-based router. I have here my XSparse expression. My XSparse expression where I look for an symbol element with the value IBM, and if this is the case, the message should be routed to this mock endpoint. I think it's simple. So let's execute this test. Let me first go into this directory. And run the test. So the tests are built on, I execute this test with Maven 3.0.4 and with Java 7. Okay, you will see this test roundabout needs 8 seconds to send 10,000 messages to the content-based router and route the message to the right endpoint. Not bad, but also not good. So for the next test, I don't change anything in my route. I only include Camel Saxon into my glass pass, because Saxon has a much much more better XPass engine than the one in the JDK. And I simply repeat the test. And we will see this test now pass much more faster. It's okay. As you can see, it needs only 4.6 seconds. Okay.
Where's the time again? I haven't seen it. I don't see on the code.
Sorry. Okay. Good, but not good enough. So let's try out XQuery, because Saxon has an XQuery implementation, which is also faster than the XPass expression. So I use the same base route test class, so I don't have to go into this again, but in my create route builder, now I use XQuery to define my XQuery expression, but it's the same expression like for XPass. And I also send this these messages to the mock endpoint if they match to this expression. Okay. Let's do this test. And we should see that using XQuery is again a bit more performant than it's a bit more performant than using XPass. So let's try to make it faster. Another language we can use in this case is VDET XML. VDET XML is GPL. So you have to think about whether you can use it or not. And because it's GPL, we host this component at Camel Extra, not at the official Apache Camel repository. And it's also the reason why we don't have DSL for this, like for the XQuery or XPass expressions. But it's not a problem. The only thing we have to provide is a predicate. Predicate is one of the core interfaces Camel has. It's simply an interface with one method which takes an exchange object and it has to return a Boolean, and that's all. So, and it's the case we implement this. We have an XPass builder from VDET XML. We use this in our when DSL, and if this expression matches, then we send the message to this mock endpoint again. And we see, again, it's faster. Okay. Is it possible to be faster? There are some possibilities. One possibility is not to use XML, XQuery, XParse things. In some cases, we can do simple things like we can check whether this XML has an element with an specific value like this one. So I think it's easy to understand. We take our body and check whether this body contains this character sequence. Okay, let's try this one. Okay. Less than 600 milliseconds. That's fast. Okay, and sometimes we also have the possibility to route on message headers. So as we can see here, we check whether the header routing condition is equals to IBM, and in this case, we send this message to this endpoint. So let's do this last test for this ARP pattern. Okay, we are again a little bit faster. Okay. In the test I did, so I run some of the tests multiple times, I got more or less this picture. If you use the XParse from the JDK, so that's, you should not do this. Oops. And yeah, so that's the times I could measure it. And the conclusion is, if you can use conditions based on your message header, you should do this. So that's the fastest one. If I go back, so it's around about 500 milliseconds to process 10,000 messages with 10 kilobyte. If it's not possible, then check whether you can use string contains check with a simple language or with some other scripting languages. If this is not possible, think about whether VDT XML is possible or not. So as I said, it's GPL license. And if this is not possible, then use XQuery. And if this is also not possible and you have to use XParse, then make sure you have the Sachsen library in your ClassParse. Okay, the next demo is about Splitter AIP, which is also a common used pattern. So I again start with an XParse test. So this split test extended the split base test. So it's again, we set up some expected method count. In this case, we expect 1,000 messages on our mock endpoint. I configure this mock endpoint to not store the messages which it receives for performance reason. Then I have a stopwatch, which I stop, because I read, in this test, I read a file from the file system. I configure this route to not stop, start up automatically if I start my camel context. So that's the reason why I start my route at this point. And then I wait until all my messages arrived in my mock component, and then I print out the time I needed. So this is my route. As I said, I read from a file endpoint in source test data file. I have a 10 megabyte file, which I read. And then I provide some other options to camel which are useful for this unit test. Almost done. Yeah. Okay, the NOP equals true means normally camel will pick up a file, and after a file is processed, camel will move it to a subdirectory, .camel. And for unit tests, it's not so good, because then before you can do the next unit test, you have to move the file back and so on. And that's a really nice option to say, camel, don't move this file. And I also use initial delay equals null, because by default, camel will wait 1 second before it starts polling the directory. Okay, after I get my file, I use an XPass expression to split this in my individual order elements, and then I send this to the mock endpoint. So let's try this with XPass. Let me check one thing before. So I do this test without Saxon in the class pass. And you will see that I get some errors. Oh, sorry. So I have to stop this test after a few seconds, because you can see it consumes all my memory, and it will not, it doesn't finish the test in 1 minute. So again, it's a really bad idea to use XPass with the JDK XPass implementation. Okay, let's use Saxon again and do the same test. Take a few seconds. Okay, 8.4 seconds. Not bad, not good. Okay. Let's try VDT XML again. So this route is really similar. We read from the same file endpoint. We split based on this XPass builder. And yeah, we send then the messages to the same mock endpoint. Okay, 5.1 second. It's a bit faster than XPath. And last but not least, for file splitting, I also have a test with the tokenized XML. Yeah, there's some simple tokenizing functionality we provide from Camel. There's no library behind this. And let's test this one. Okay, it takes a bit longer than VDT XML. And at the end, I got a similar result with XPath expression JDK. I could not process such a big XML file, so it was 100 megabytes. With Saxon, it took around about 8.8 seconds. With VDT XML, 5.1 seconds. And with the XML tokenizer, 7.4 seconds. I also measured the memory footprint, and it's also important if you process such a big file. And as you can see, the XPath JDK needs 1.1 gigabyte. If you use Saxon, it's only 480 megabytes. With VDT XML, it's around about 200 megabyte, and if you use the XML tokenizer, it was only 8 megabyte. So my conclusion is, if it's possible for you to use VDT XML, then use VDT XML. If it's not possible, then try to use the XML tokenizer. It supports namespaces, but it has also some limitations. And if both are not possible for you, then you can, of course, use XPath, but then make again sure you have the Saxon library in your ClassPath. Okay, for the next example, I want to show you some marshalling and unmarshalling functionality Camel provides. So that's again the base class for this test. It's really similar like the first one. I set up my template to send all the messages to this direct start endpoint. I create my Java object, which is shown here. It's a base docs object with JaxB annotations for the JaxB test, of course. Then I put 10 orders into this base docs object. Afterwards, I warm up my system again. So I send 10,000 messages to this mock endpoint. I reset my mock endpoint at the end. And then I set my expectations again, start my stopwatch, send all the 10,000 messages again, stop my watch, and check how long does it take. Okay, let's start with an Xtreme marshaller, because Xtreme is well known. And by the way, all the tests are available on GitHub. I put it the URL in my slides. Okay, as you can see, it took almost 3 seconds to process or to marshal and unmarshal 10,000 messages with Xtream. Okay, let's check whether we have other possibilities. Another possibility is to use XML beans. So it's simply the similar route. I read from my direct start endpoint, marshal using XML beans, unmarshal it back using XML beans, and I send this message to the mock endpoint. Okay, 2 seconds, a little bit faster. Okay, let's see whether we can do more. Of course, we have JuxB. For JuxB, I configure the JuxB data format to use not pretty print. And let's see how fast JuxB is. Two point 4 seconds. That's not really the. Let's run it again. Yeah, from time to time you get some. Bad numbers, which is not really representative. 206. Okay. I don't want to go through all the marshalling and unmarshalling possibilities we have, but I will show you two more. One is Jackson JSON marshaller, because XML is not the only possibility we have. Okay, and you can see it's much more faster. It's only 1.1 seconds. And for me, the interesting question was also, how long does it take if you use the normal Java serialization mechanism? So, which you can also do in CAML with marshal serialization and unmarshal serialization. Okay, let's have a look how long does it take. Okay, and you can see Java serialization is not faster than using JSON. That's what surprised me a little bit, but it's good to see. Okay. At the end, during my tests, I got the following result. This is a RV. Need roundabout 3.1 seconds using Xtream, 2.3 seconds using XML beans, 2.2 seconds using JuxB, 1.8 seconds using JIBX. If you use Xtream in JSON, it took 5 seconds. Surprised me also a little bit. Using JSON, 1.2 seconds, 800 milliseconds, or In this case, now we had 1.1 seconds for Jackson and Java serialization 1.1 second. Okay, one thing I have to mention is JIBX, which was the fastest serialization and deserialization mechanism for XML, doesn't work with Java 7 really well. If you use some list elements, then you will get some errors. That's bad, but that's the case. In this case, you should consider using JAX-B. But if you can use a JSON form marshalling, you should use definitely Jackson. And from my point of view, there's no reason to use Java serialization. It's not interoperable. It's not easy to read. There's no really reason for. Okay. In the next example, I will show you some improvements you can make if you're working with files. Okay, this is my route. I will read a file from the source test data directory. I will split this file based on the body and the backslash n character. I stream this body, do not load the entire file into memory. And then for each individual line, I will write this line into a new file in my target directory. I think this test take a while. Okay, 14 seconds to process this file. It's a lot. And the reason why it's a lot, it's because for each line we send to this file, Camel will open a new file handle, write this line into this file and close this again. So that's a lot of file opening and file closing things happen. Okay, there are possibilities to improve this. So one possibility to improve this is to use an aggregator. In this case, we batch 1,000 lines together into one line or into one exchange object. And we also configured a completion timeout of 200 milliseconds, which means if there is no new messages, or if no new message arrived in this aggregator within 200 milliseconds, then this exchange will be finished and flushed. Then we configured a string aggregation strategy. That's also one of the core interfaces Camel has. we use this in multiple enterprise integration patterns like the multicast, the enricher, and also in the aggregator. And it simply has one method aggregate, and in this aggregate method, it takes two exchanges, one old exchange, one new exchange, and what you have to do is to combine both exchanges and return one. So in this case, if I receive the first message, then the old exchange will be null. In this case, I read the data, my body from my new exchange, put this, put in a backslash n before, and then return the new exchange. And for all subsequent exchanges, I simply append my new exchange on the existing body in my old exchange. Okay. Let's test whether this is a good idea or not. And in a few seconds, we will see that's not the best idea, because there are a lot of string concatenations going on. And at the end, this test needs some little bit more time. So 18 seconds. Okay. A better thing we could do is so that's really the same setup with one difference. In this case, we use a string builder aggregation strategy. And this string builder aggregation strategy uses, of course, a string builder to do all the concatenations. And we do not concatenate so many strings. Okay, let's test how fast this is. Okay, it's 4 seconds. If you remember, the first time it was 14 seconds. Okay, that's the test I made. The first test was a little bit more than 14 seconds by writing line by line to the output file using string concatenation and batching 1,000 lines together. It took a bit longer, but using a string builder instead of string concatenation, it's 4.3 seconds. Another possibility in Camel is to use the stream component. We also have a stream component, which means we stream the content into a file. And the fastest implementation was to use the built-in aggregator. Let me show you this. This is this line, which is a bit different. If you use split ARP. Camel normally use a default aggregation strategy, which will send the file which comes to the splitter to the next endpoints after the splitter, after the splitting is done. But you can also provide your own aggregation strategy. That's what I did in this case. The advantage is you don't have to configure how big the batch should be or not, because the split component knows when all the elements are split and finished. Okay, the conclusion is use an aggregator to reduce the number of file access. And if it's possible, use a built-in one. There may some cases where this is not possible if this file is too big. And of course, use a string builder to concatenate strings. So the next one is using databases. So in Camel, we have, as Kai mentioned, we have multiple components to talk to a database. For this example, I use a SQL component. So this test is really simple. In my setup method, I use an embedded database builder from Spring to set up an embedded Derby database and to initialize my database. I also put my data source into my registry. This is because in my endpoint URI for my SQL component, I have to provide the data source. So this test, it's triggered again by a direct start endpoint, and it will execute an insert statement into my order table. And this component expects a list or an iterable. And for each of my elements, I will replace this and then send a message to the mock endpoint so that my unit test knows, okay, when all the messages are processed. And the other stuff is like for the other tests. So this is my list object I use for this test. I set some values, and then I do, again, 10,000 iterations. Okay, as you can see, 3.4 seconds. In this test, we have a similar issue like writing entries line by line into a file. So we have a lot of I/O traffic, and one thing to improve this is again to use an aggregator. So in this case, it batches together 10 messages, and send this to a database, which reduce the amount of the number of database calls we have to do. And of course, in this example, I use an embedded database. In real life, you have to talk about TCP/IP with your database, which means the difference you will see is much more larger. And as you can see here, now it takes only 1.3 seconds to send all the 10,000 entries to the database. So the numbers I measured was this one. If I write the entries record by record, I need round about 3.2 seconds. If I batch this together, it doesn't really matter whether it's 10, 100, or 1,000 records. Yeah. And the conclusion, again, is to use an aggregator to batch together the messages and limit the database access. Because I'm running a little bit out of time, I will only show you some code examples and don't execute the test. Another possibility we have in Camel is a thread DSL, which is really useful if you want to process some messages in parallel. Let's start with this one. So in this case, we again pull a directory, read and file. We have a processor which simulates some expensive processing. And at the end, we will send this message to the mock endpoint. The bad thing here is that Camel will pick up the next file only after this file is processed, which means after 1 second. If you use the threads DSL, we introduce a thread pool, and Camel will run in 10 parallel threads to process this message, which means it will pick up the file, hand it over to a thread, and then go back and read the next file. By doing this, you can see that it, of course, depends how many threads you configured. You can speed up or parallelize your execution, and by using 10 threads, you can see, okay, it needs more or less, Or if I don't use this thread DSL, I need 10 times more. Yeah, if it's possible to parallelize your work, then use thread DSL. Another example is using templates. It's also commonly used to sending some mails. You normally use a velocity template or a FreeMaker template or a string template. These are the three template mechanisms Camel provides out of the box. They are all really similar. As you can see here, I read again a message from my direct endpoint. In this case, I call my FreeMaker template. I call the FreeMaker component, which will pick up this FreeMaker template, do the string replacement, and then send the message to the mock endpoint. The templates are really similar. I have text, I have some expressions, and that's all. So I did the test for this trees component, and yeah, the string template was the one which takes most of time, 3.1 second, and the FreeMaker template engine was the fastest one with 1 second to process 10,000 messages. Okay, the conclusion is prefer FreeMaker or Velocity and don't use the string template. Okay, because Dan also has a talk about Camel and CXF today, I do not go into detail in this, but the conclusion is if you use CXF, make sure you have Woodstock in your class pass, because Woodstock is a much more performant Stux engine than the one from the JDK. And think about whether you need the Java object for your further processing or whether you only need the XML payload or the entire SOAP message. Because in this case, we can skip the unmarshaller step. And of course, you have to fine-tune your container, Jetty or Tomcat, and to use the right settings for your connector, acceptor, and I also prepared a demo for messaging. Okay, one thing you should know about the JMS component is if you have to use the in-out message exchange pattern, Camel will by default use a temporary queue. This is the case if you in this way, you only send your message to an in-out queue and listen on the response, and after response received, Camel process this exchange further. If you use an explicitly configured reply to queue, then make sure you use reply to type equals exclusive, if you can use this. This will speed up your listening part, or set a receive timeout which fits your need. By default, Camel has a receive timeout from 1 second, which means if I put a message into a queue, Camel will start after 1 second to read the response, which is in most cases not really performant because you receive your response after a few milliseconds. But if there's no reason not to use temporary queues, then use temporary queues. And if you can rewrite your route to use in only message exchange pattern, then use this, because this is much more faster, because you don't have to wait for the response of the second queue before you can process this further. So in this case, I configured the second route with concurrent consumers equals 5. And at the end, it's round about 5 times faster because I achieved some parallel processing here. I also have an example about the new SJMS component coming with Camel 2.11, where you can do some batch things for the consumer and producer, which means the producer can send a list to the SJMS endpoint and the SGMS endpoint will iterate over this list and send all the messages to the broker. And on the consumer part, we have the possibility to make some batch acknowledgments. So we don't acknowledge each and every message. So you can configure it in this way that you consume 100 or 1,000 messages and then send a commit. What is faster than commit each and every single message? Okay, so as I say, the code is available on GitHub. Try it out. I hope you could see it. It's not so complicated to set up some tests with Camel, do your own performance tests for your own needs and see what works best for you. So now I'm open for questions. I would say it really depends on your route. I think I cannot answer this for all use cases. Okay, thank you.